What a fool I was. The sound of bones crunching echoes in the hallway, giving you some pause. Peering around the corner, you see two zombies hunched over an adventurer's bloody corpse, eating it with gusto. They are both collared and chained to a robed cultist who watches with deranged smile. Add a random challenge modifier. Let's trigger the encounter. You step in to stop the depravity. Seems like some uninvited guest boys, the cultist says as he motions to you. The zombies instinctively react and start attacking you. Okay. I think we knew that was coming. This moves me to the front, which I think is okay. I need to get rid of Malice. I like Herd. That's cool. All right, you're already hitting the right person. Now, does Chill go through armor? This is the question. No. Good. Also, I think the wolves should be, like, super fast, just as a matter of opinion. Oh, should have tried to get some healing on Alphonse, for sure. Vile Branch. Ice and poison. Okay. Map has been modified. Rare drop, difficult terrain. Let's try and get a little more damaged before we go further. Okay, we have two actions left. 10 by 3? You're hitting the dog, right? Yeah, okay, let's do that. I am so good at failing to take advantage of the dog, what can I say? But that's fun. Okay, let's get some healing on Alphonse, maybe. Beautiful. Okay, so okay, so we get some observe going. The wolves are actually doing something. Okay. We still have the cultist to deal with. Oh, it's a speedy cultist, eh? Why is there a line drawn between them? That's interesting. I'm just gonna top everybody up, I think. Yeah, I think that's it. Do that so the wolf gets some action. Alright, I don't think the wolf's gonna get any action, unfortunately. We can let the wolf get the kill, right? This will prove if I actually understand how the turn order works. I do. Strength and a little extra SP. Alright, I picked the wrong one last time. Alright, that should go on someone. Do you have good rings? No. You, in fact, are sitting on one ring that's not good at all. Beautiful. Need to clean up the inventory in a big way. What a swift kill. Yeah. I think keeping it working is going to be good. And as enemies' HP increases, that can become more difficult. Now, I also... Now, show me your deck. Why do you have Malice? You have Malice because of one of the items that I equipped on you, this Umbra Belt. Can I just edit the deck and remove Malice? No, because it's on an item, I can't get rid of it. I so rarely see opportune moment, I feel like. I don't think we need Faint anymore. Or Observe, really. Observe is good for setting up some big kills, but I think we'll do that. I want to make them a little more reliable. Let's see. Can't help but feel like we're about to get besieged here. This one's gonna come over and do damage, isn't it? No? Alright. Nothing else to that. Ooh, we haven't seen this node before. A glittering trove of treasures. Nice. Let's wend our way around for efficiency's sake. So, precog. Retain one additional card for 3 turns. Oh. I thought that also had draw on it. Jeez, I'm doing a whole lot of nothing right now. I'm gonna switch with Alphonse here. Just because I think we need a big turn. So I'll hang on to that. Oh, wrong ability. Okay, now we have big crit. That's a many hits. Oh, that was only 3x13. Never mind. That seems really strong. Gravity Surge. Need a little healing here, and there are all of my wolf cards at the bottom of my deck, not where I needed them. Let's do our level ups. Now we could put another one here. Oh, why is this one big and yellow? Oh, this is Warrior 3. This seems interesting. And then we'll start working over towards it. Might have wanted to get another tier one talent there. We could have gone here, 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 and here, but I guess not the end of the world. Ah, I'm still kicking myself for losing that that item. Now, this should grant one additional action. I think that's the way that works. What is this? Reveal two random nodes. Okay. We go a level deeper. Oh. Treasure Golem right off the bat. This is. Oh, the mushrooms are a supply. Interesting. I think this is all we're getting. Well, it'd be close to get to the Wandering Peddler. Now let's roll the dice on it. Yeah, because we get one of these. We can top up on those. Do I want another one of these? I don't think so. Maybe one more. All right. Let's see what this glittering trove of treasures is. Leather hood with dexterity on it. Nice. Hysteria. Grants scare. Apply 14 vulnerable. If this was free, it would be better. More channeling, more spell attack damage. All right. Do we go over here? I think we're gonna come back around to that. So let's go this way. I'm saving this in case we need it later. Fade to shadows. Move to any row. Move to any cell in the back row. All right, we're gonna get a couple more of these mini games. This one's gonna wander, but I think we can grab Pierre and hope that it kind of goes this way. Oh, that's right. I forgot. Pierre fires us off into the ether. All right, so those are coming in fast and furious. I'm gonna do this to try and skirt around this thing. Ooh, going down is potentially going to cause us damage. We'll see. Oh, okay. We got lucky. Okay, some random wand. Let's get all the way on the far edge of you. Wow, we're just swimming in relics. But we're not going to make it over here. We could get this, but we'd likely get snagged. Well, maybe not. Let's try it out. I think it's gonna move. I don't think it's gonna. All right. It did indeed move exactly in the direction we didn't want it to. Oh, yeah, you live and you learn, right? You come across a marked stone altar hidden in the shadow of a crevasse. There is a receptacle on its surface for a single item. There are what looks like enchanting runes engraved on it. Okay. So we think this is going to improve an item. That's my suspicion. So what's an item that would be easy to use? Oh, so these are the items that are currently equipped. Okay. Oh, so this includes all the weapons that are currently equipped. I see. Well, that's good. Let's try this one, Pain Song. Becomes Brimstone Conduit. Okay, so we gain one int off of it, and now we can associate something with it. Maybe one of these, and then that's not very useful. Okay. We haven't figured out the runes yet, that's for sure. All right, let's kill some spiders, though. So we can gain an AP by doing that. Put down a wolf and move you. I like the battlefield manipulation we get from that. Just give me another slash. Now, I want to test this out. I think that the wolf is going to trigger our attack of opportunity. So that's 7 plus 11, that's 18. Well, I think we'll see the animation when the wolf goes. Okay, so we didn't move, which doesn't mean that it doesn't work. It could be that we just didn't need it. But we'll need to keep testing that, because using wolves to fire off attack of opportunity, I think, could be... Why is there a random bear here? I should have probably been paying attention. Okay, we Hidden Blade. We Prowl to move to here. We do this so that we have like a straight line across. Alphonse does not disappoint. Good job, Bear. Okay. How much? The bear had 52 hit points. Okay. Area grants one fate on clear. Area occupied by skeletons. Let's go explore a bit. We have plenty of supplies, and I'm thinking if we get an opportunity to use some fate, that could be useful. So I'm going to come up here. Treasure Goblin didn't do exactly what I expected it to, but probably missed out on some goodies here. Should have potentially went deeper. I was hoping we'd get a reroll opportunity. Grab this, because I'm not gonna come back to it later. This dungeon's definitely more interesting. I'll use a strange incense. We can use a... We don't need to do that, though. Okay, enemies are one level higher isn't a great modifier to get, but... You'll be aided by a spirit wolf. I wonder if these modifiers are because we're using the summoner already, and I wonder if it will be affected by well-trained... First time we haven't picked up the the kill thing in a while. Okay, Wolf is tanking nicely for us if anything survives. All right, wolves. Do your best. Nice. This is when having herds is very useful, I guess. Or just having Alphonse, I guess, is also nice. Okay, so this time, click the one that you actually want. AP increased by one? What? Holy cow. That's really good, I think. Animal kinship two? Okay, another spirit wolf. Your soul link beasts have beast attack one additional time. Ooh. What does taunt do? Force an enemy to attack. Okay. Add one rank to one card in the targeted soul link beast deck. It's gotta be wild cunning here. Double attack seems very strong. The lich meter is getting a little full. We don't get the kill yet. Now we do, though. Oh, wow. This is blocked by the trait, and it's still doing 85. What is the trait? Hold on. Removes all charges on all units at turn start. Takes 30%. More stored damage from status effects. Takes 50% less damage from any other source. So this is doing half damage and it's doing 85, so it would be doing 160 otherwise. Okay. Alphonse is cruising. Do you even have a attack of opportunity? Do I care about attack of opportunity? I kind of don't think I do. I'm wondering how close we are to Alphonse being able to use the Raider Ring. Or the Raider's Ring. Our inventory is getting to be kind of a disaster. Grants a fate on clear. I haven't spent a fate. That's okay. Get a spirit wolf out there. All right, that was probably not useful. Okay, we have to use our free action. Move you to here. That was probably an error. It warned me about thorns. Probably should have been a little careful. Move it back so that this thing has taken the damage. Gravity Surge being free just seems completely ridiculous. Order was probably very wrong there. I should have been applying Bleed first. Alright, Cultist Floor 2. The clock is getting full. I wonder if this is the bad guy. Let's kill some spiders first. Okay, if we draw a card, we gain an AP, so we'll do that. I'm just going to clear out this bottom area, I think. Okay. The summon build is, it's just too slow to go for Alphonse. Feels kind of like a bummer. Anybody need healing? Yeah, because of the thorns. There we go. And I want to look at your hand. So you can also do, on turn start, gain 4 critical for every bleed on all enemies. Oh, this is passive, and this passive. When killed, owner will take... Okay, and that's the soul link thing. Got it. Oh, so we can use javelins to... We can use javelins to put bleeds on enemies that will then buff the wolves. Because they sense the blood in the water or something. Let's see what this is. You spot a lever and a pulley along the hallway, which holds a ceiling chandelier in place. Several skeletons mill about in the adjacent foyer, unaware of the presence. There might be an opportunity to take them out with one well-timed pull. Yeah, Alphonse has this. Add a random reward modifier to a nearby node, add a random challenge. Yeah, we'll just... Alphonse has got this. A critical success. You time it perfectly, the chandelier drops down on the gang of skeletons, obliterating them. A node on the map has been modified. Okay.